STS-47 was the 50th Space Shuttle mission of the program, as well as the second mission of Space Shuttle Endeavour. The mission mainly involved conducting experiments in life and material sciences. Crew. Topic: Backup crew. Topic: Crew seating arrangements. Topic: Mission highlights. Spacelab J — a joint NASA and National Space Development Agency of Japan (NASDA) mission using a manned Spacelab module — conducted microgravity investigations in materials and life sciences. The international crew, consisting of the first Japanese astronaut to fly aboard the shuttle, the first African-American woman to fly in space and, contrary to normal NASA policy, the first married couple to fly on the same space mission, Lee and Davis, was divided into red and blue teams for around-the-clock operations. Spacelab J included 24 materials science and 20 life sciences experiments, of which 35 were sponsored by NASDA, 7 by NASA and 2 collaborative efforts. Ever since female space travelers became the norm during the 1980s, NASA instituted rules stipulating that husband-wife couples would not be launched together out of concern over disrupting in-flight morale. However, Mark Lee and Jan Davis had secretly married a few weeks before the launch of STS-47 and NASA was forced to waive this rule as it would not have been possible to cancel the mission or reassign crews at this point. The first married couple in space created months of speculation and jibes from the media about the possibility of them having sexual relations in orbit, but NASA officials were not amused and vehemently shot down the rumors, noting among other things the lack of privacy in the cramped shuttle cabin and the physics of zero gravity making intercourse difficult if not impossible. Davis and Lee, who later divorced, refused to answer queries about them engaging in intimate activities during the mission. Materials science investigations covered such fields as biotechnology, electronic materials, fluid dynamics and transport phenomena, glasses and ceramics, metals and alloys, and acceleration measurements. Life sciences included experiments on human health, cell separation and biology, developmental biology, animal and human physiology and behavior, space radiation, and biological rhythms. Test subjects included the crew, Japanese koi fish, carp, cultured animal and plant cells, chicken embryos, fruit flies, fungi, plant seeds, frogs and frog eggs, and oriental hornets. 12 getaway special gas canisters, 10 with experiments, 2 with ballast, were carried in the payload bay. MIDIC experiments were, Israeli Space Agency investigation about hornets ISIAH, Solid Surface Combustion Experiment SSCE, Shuttle Amateur Radio Experiment SAREX-2, Air Force Maui Optical Site AMOS, and Ultraviolet Plume Imager UVPI. Among the gas canisters was G-102, sponsored by the Boy Scouts of America's Exploring Division in cooperation with the TRW Systems Integration Group, Fairfax, VA. The project was named Project POSTAR and was the first space experiment created entirely by members of the Boy Scouts of America. The mission, scheduled to end on September 19, was extended for one more day to complete certain experiments. Also on board were two experiments prepared by Ashford School in Kent, United Kingdom, which, at the time, was a girls-only school. The school had won a competition run by Independent Television News. The experiments were contained in G520. The first one injected a few grams of cobalt nitrate crystals to a sodium silicate to create a chemical garden in weightless condition. The growths, which were photographed 66 times as they developed, spread out in random directions, twisted, and, in some cases, formed spirals. A second experiment to investigate how Lasergang rings formed in space failed to operate correctly due to friction in parts of the mechanism. On its return, the experiment was exhibited in the London Science Museum. See also: List of human spaceflights, List of Space Shuttle missions, Nikon NASA F4, Outline of space science, Project POSTAR, Space Shuttle.